playing from right to left to get the game underway as the noise builds up from the Russian fans. Yamyanenko playing it forward, the captain. There's Graham Roberts going across. So a solitary task up front tonight for Ali McCoist for Rangers. There's the Dynamo captain, Yamyanenko, captain of club and country. Here's McCoist with the layoff. Kuznetsov wins it again. A good challenge though by Cohen. Durant holding off Kuznetsov. McCoist trying to find Durant with that pass inside, but it's collected by Yamyanenko at the back for Dynamo. Chanov plays it out. This is Vesanov. Now Mikhailichenko. Yakovenko. Lock in. Yevtushenko's through the middle. Butcher got across. And good covering play by the Rangers captain, Terry Butcher. But a promising build-up that was Yevtushenko finding a gap at the edge of the box going through. Butcher came across to make the clearance. Yamyanenko will take the corner kick. Everyone back for Rangers except McCoist. Yamyanenko to the post. And that was well covered by Jimmy Phillips at the near post area. Not once but twice. He had to concede another corner kick. Yamyanenko right footed again. Headed by Mikhailichenko, and it was taken easily by Woods. The big number 8 got up well though, and he was unchallenged when he directed the header on goal. Kuznetsov's header. A push in the back on Mikhailichenko by Derek Ferguson. Free kick to Dynamo. Altashar starts a slow build-up once again. There's no question though in the early stages that Rangers have succeeded in taking all the pace out of the Dynamo Kiev build-up. That was a deliberate ploy, and there's a foul on McCoist by Kuznetsov. Well, Kuznetsov is renowned for taking no prisoners, and McCoist felt that all right. Phil Bosma coming on to administer the treatment to the Rangers centre-forward. McCoist is back on his feet. Durant has gone forward for Rangers. That's gone behind McCoist. Yamyanenko again. Mikhailichenko. Long pass, Phillips challenging. He's missed just that. Here's trouble for Rangers. Yaremchuk coming in, and the final cross not good enough, but the danger's not yet over. Collected by Rats. Now Yakovenko. Roberts with the header, only as far as Vesanov. Dynamo by Vesanov. Woods going across to cover, but that was dangerous for Rangers. All sparked off by that move, building up on the right, when Jimmy Phillips misjudged the challenge on Yaremchuk. Indeed, the cross from Yaremchuk could have been better, caused Rangers more problems. As it was worked out, it was Vesanov in the end who rifled the shot wide. Sunis, Butcher. Careless one from Butcher, picked up by Yaremchuk. Here's blocking. Rats gets away from Ferguson and from Tunis. Still Rats. Away from Butcher. And Ferguson went all the way back to make that clearing header. Mikhailichenko has possession though for Dynamo. Butcher's tackle. Here's Ferguson. Now McGregor. McCoist sets off again. Willing as ever, he's away from Kuznetsov. Here's McCoist in the box. No support. He'll have to do it by himself. Ali McCoist! And Chanov got down to block the shot. Frustration for McCoist, but that was superb play from the striker. Chanov gesticulating to his defence and no one. There was brilliant play from McCoy's coming in, the shot in the end blocked by the Russian keeper. Baldišar once more. Switching play to the left to Demyanenko. Mikhailichenko. Yakovenko. Roberts with the header here, Durant. Supported immediately by Sunnis. Here's McCoist. Taken on the back again by Kuznetsov. The referee away's play on this time. McCoist is still on the ground as Durant makes the tackle on Demyanenko. This time the referee from Austria gives a free kick to Dynamo Kiev. McCoist is still on the ground, but the referee will not allow the play to stop at the moment. There's McCoist. Taken from the back once again by Oleg Kuznetsov. There was no foul given. And Phil Bosma is being asked to take McCoist off the field. McCoist is clearly in a lot of pain. So here's the tackle which inflicted that damage on McCoist. Well, that certainly looked to me to be a clear foul. Fans Borer certainly popular enough with the Russian fans, but no question there that McCoy seemed to be very hard done by. Besenov. Sunnis collides with McGregor. Yakovenko playing it through and no chance at all for Blokhin. And Oleg Blokhin made his disgust clear as far as that pass was concerned. Woods with a long ball aimed for McCoist. Kuznetsov wins it. Cohen inside. There's McGregor. Kuznetsov beaten by McCoist. There's a great chance for Rangers. The side netting from McGregor. He was set up by Durant. And what an opportunity that was. John McGregor supporting the attack. It was McCoist who did the good work initially with that head flick on. Then Durant guiding the ball into the path of John McGregor on his weaker foot, the right, slicing the shot against the stanchion on the outside. Well, certainly great encouragement for Rangers so far with two great attempts on goal. The first from McCoist, the second from McGregor. And that certainly has silenced the Russian crowd once again. Yevtushenko forced to come deep to become involved in the play. Yaravchuk. Hopeful one there across which Ferguson wins. Yakovenko plays it wide again. Besenov to Yakovenko. He wasn't picked up making that run. In the middle, Roberts couldn't make it, but Nickel did. Here's Derek Ferguson. Blokhin sends it back. Demyanenko with rats on the outside, made the play from Dynamo Kiev. The shot played in first time and blocked to allow rats to accept the throw. Demyanenko holding on Ryalovchuk, well, holding up Durant. Here's Demyanenko. Oh, that bounced off quickly away from Chris Woods. The referee has given a corner kick, so Woods get a touch. The shot certainly wasn't hit with very much power. We'll see this as the ball is played inside from Yaremchuk. Shot to Demyanenko. Hit it with his right foot, not very powerfully. And Woods appeared to dive a shade early, deceived by the lack of pace in the shot, I think. Demyanenko coming very close indeed for Dynamo. Here's the corner kick. In swinger. Woods under pressure, and he reacted well as Mikhailichenko came in. Besenov plays it short. There's Mikhailichenko. piece of running from Yevtushenko. Here's Ratz getting in the cross first time, but the flag was up on the near side. Well, that's all cosmetic. Yakubenko showing his finishing ability, but all to no avail. An offside flag was up, and the free kick's been given to Rangers. The ball played forward, catching Ratz offside. A couple of yards in it, I think. And Woods had stopped playing at this point as Yakubenko eased the ball into the net. So it looks as though Rangers have survived the first half. 45 minutes are over. We're into time added on for that brief stoppage to give treatment to Ali McCoist. The Austrian referee checking with his linesman, and there goes the half-time whistle. An excellent first 45 minutes from Rangers. They've tied things up in the middle of the field. They've been very secure at the back, and they've had the bonus of the running power of McCoist, supported by Durant up front. So an excellent first half for Rangers. The halftime score, Dynamo Kiev 0, Rangers 0. Indeed, here inside the Central Stadium, as Dynamo Kiev start to come forward again with Yaramchuk, inside is Mikhailchenko. That's cut up by Roberts for Sunis. Tried to play that beyond Kuznetsov for McCoist, but it's won by the blonde centre-back. Here's Demyarenko. Good header on from Yaramchuk. Again, chance now for Dynamo Kiev. And it was well blocked by Phillips. He did well, standing his ground there, blocking the cross. Rangers, for just a second, appear to be exposed. Veselov in particular, this is Mikhailchenko. Coming inside, robbed easily by Sunis, and McCoist sprints off on the right, all on his own for the moment. He may try it by himself, running into Kuznetsov. Yaramchuk. Yakubenko. Yakubenko being allowed to come a long way forward, he's still in possession. No blocking. Deep cross, too deep for Ratz. Rangers trying to regain their poise now, getting men back. Here's Demyarenko! Powerful enough, but well off target. It was Ratz indeed with the final shot. Playing it back into the path of the oncoming player now. And that's well wide of Wood's right-hand post. In the middle of the field with Besenov. Oh, good running by Besenov. Yevtushenko. Yakubenko. Straining forward, playing in a good cross. There's Roberts. Fine defensive header by Graham Roberts. He got up behind Terry Butcher to make that difference. That's been a feature of the Rangers' play in the centre of defence. Butcher and Roberts covering each other superbly. And the roar building up from the Russian fans. They're sensing some prospect of a breakthrough. Ferguson on the near post. Roberts waits to attack the ball. Played in by Ratz. That was Butcher's challenge. Phillips didn't get a very good clearance. There's Ratz. Engineering an angle for himself. Rangers defence very diligent indeed, closing down, and there's Ferguson. Loose pass forward, Yaramchuk goes forward, still Yaramchuk. Tackled firmly by McGregor. Suddenly the pace of the play has been lifted by the Russians. There's Yaramchuk. Jimmy Nichols' header, here's block in. Now Ratz making for the byline, good play from Dynamo Kiev. The cross again, too long. It's a let-off for Rangers, played forward by McGregor. Oh, he's trying a back killer. Yakubenko plays it inside. Here's Besenov. Now Mikhailchenko. Suddenly the Russians have come to life. There's Yevtushenko going up. And he's again well covered by Roberts and Phillips. Still approaching the hour mark. And here's the first substitution of the match. Yevtushenko is coming off. And Yevseyev is coming on. Now that is very interesting indeed, because Yevseyev, by nature, is a central defender. And that's a replacement for a striker. Bessonov, Demyanenko, Garat. This is where they may benefit from Mikhailichenko. Of course, Yaremchuk, he couldn't make it. The SAF, played across by Yakovenko. And they're all crowding round, blocking at the far post. Nicol and Roberts to make certain they didn't get a clear header. Corner kick's been conceded. Lots of activity now in the Rangers box. And you can hear what the Russian fans think of all this, with the noise building up around the stadium. Firmly headed away by Butcher. Rangers sprinting out of the box. And just as well, Woods get his body behind that. A very powerful shot from Bessonov. Well, the Austrian linesman waiting to complete the paperwork as Cohen takes all the time in the world to leave the field. A gentle jog now at the instance of the referee. Well, straight replacement, I'm sure. Dave Kirkwood will go into right midfield. Durant runs into space once again. What an outstanding match he's had, supporting Ali McCost. Kuznetsov. SAF. Kuznetsov. Gorgic goes into challenge. This is Yaremchuk. No block in. Got a good play from block in. He appeared to be fouled at the edge of the box. Yes. Jimmy Nicholls tackled. Blocking was fouled. He hoped for a penalty kick, but it certainly was outside the box. There's no doubt about that. We'll see it again in the replay. It's great play, this though, from blocking. 106 Russian caps, and here you see why. Brought down right at the edge of the box. No question about the foul. And a problem here for the Rangers' defence. Blocking has left this. Rangers laying up a substantial wall. Out of the danger area to John McGregor. Yaremchuk challenged. McGregor misjudged that. There's Yakovenko. There's an opportunity on the far side with Rats. Came off Kirkwood to Demyanenko. Jimmy Nicol trying to block the cross and a fine tackle by Nicol. Corner kick conceded. Some faint appeals for a foul against Nicol for that challenge, but good sliding tackle by the fullback. So more pressure for the Rangers defence. Can they hold out? Demyanenko looking for Yakovenko. Across the FCF, he's challenged by Kirkwood. And the shot came from Bessonov. Off target, and another let off for the Rangers defence. Shot well wide of the target. Durant to McCoist. Here's McGregor. Put away by Kuznetsov. Good pass from Nicol. The early ball collected by Kirkwood. Now Durant. Fine effort from Ian Durant. Bringing out that superb save from Chanov. Well, where Durant gets the energy, I really don't know. He took the pass here from Kirkwood, took a few steps forward, saw the opportunity, and that's a great effort, touched over the top by the keeper. Chanov earning his money for Dynamo with that save, and Ian Durant appears to be completely tired. He's now taking the corner kick. McGregor goes for it. Here's McCoy's Keitan. Some frustration there. Graham Roberts wanted a short pass played to the side. Terry Butcher was rather, was beside him. McGregor challenging it, came across to McCoist. And you'll see Butcher appearing on his outside. He tried to turn by himself and the shot is wide. And the Russians come forward again with Bessonov. Long ball looking for Yaramchuk. That's McGregor he has to beat. Short one to Nikolachenko, tackled by Ferguson. Retaining possession well, brought down at the edge of the box by Roberts. Now that was more dangerous, it's a penalty kick. Yes, it did appear to be inside the box. The referee giving a decision without any delay. Now let's look at this again. Nikolachenko holding up Ferguson. It seems to me that he got over the 18-yard line and was brought down there, which was inside the box. Controversial moment. Oleg Blokhin will take the penalty kick. He misses very few indeed. So it's Blokhin against Woods. The scorer of 41 international goals and 106 appearances. And Blokhin leaves it to Mikhailichenko. Calmly finished by Mikhailichenko. Woods had no chance at all. And Dynamo Kiev get the goal. They wanted so badly from the start of the match. Well, certainly a controversial moment, but no question about the quality of the penalty kick. Mikhailichenko with the left foot stroking that away from Woods, sending him the wrong way. And the Rangers players still feel aggrieved about the penalty kick. A lot of Woods spoken to, referee Vorer. The Rangers players clearly thought that was outside the box. But I think the replay settled the argument that it was just about a step inside. Ferguson. McGregor, a crunching tackle from Yevseyev. Now that really was a wild one by the fullback. Came straight into the back of McGregor and the first yellow card of the match. Delivered to Yevseyev. His only grievance must be, I think, after this tackle. Watch this again. McGregor coming into it, and there's the scything tackle from Yevseyev. And his only complaint can be that Kuznetsov has managed to do that three or four times without receiving the same penalty. The clock ticking away. Seconds only left for play. The foul against Nikolachenko, who blocked the kick out from Woods, but it doesn't matter. The whistle goes by my watch a few seconds early. Dynamo Kiev, the winners by 1-0. And it's all down to the penalty kick incident, which is so controversial. 17 minutes from the end, when Roberts tackled Mikhailichenko, it did appear to be just inside the box. The penalty kick was given. Mikhailichenko stroked the ball home. Otherwise, a superb performance from Rangers. They controlled things throughout the match. The defense was secure. Midfield battled hard, and indeed they could have snatched the goal in the first half. So overall, an excellent performance and a very good chance for Rangers in the second leg in 2 weeks' time.
I'm sure you